The federal government still has billions of dollars in COVID aid left over for small businesses in low-income areas. Tens of thousands of North Texas business owners qualify for this money, but the CBS 11 I-team found that very few are actually applying for it. Investigative reporter Brian New tonight explaining what the government says is the holdup.
Even though the doors are open and North Texans are back to spending, many small businesses are still struggling to recoup losses from the past year. The U.S. Small Business Administration says it still has billions of dollars to help these businesses, up to $10,000 grants in a program that targets small businesses in low-income areas. The SBA sent out this email to nearly 12 million eligible businesses, inviting them to apply for this money.
And yet, we discovered few businesses have. Less than one in five businesses who received an invitation for this $10,000 grant has taken the SBA up on its offer. This program has $30 billion, and so far, only $2 billion has made it into the hands of small businesses.
Yes, there's a lot of money out there.
SBA District Director Herbert Austin says he gets calls daily from small business owners looking for help. When he asked them about the $10,000 grants, many of them tell him they were afraid to click on the email.
So do you think a lot of people, when they got that initial email, may have thought that it could have been a scam?
Oh, absolutely. 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 That's what they're telling us.
Over the past year, we've been warned to be on the lookout for scam artists using COVID relief aid to trick people into giving up their personal information or even money. But in this case, the SBA says it's not a scam and will be sending out emails every 15 days to qualifying businesses, hoping to reach those still in need of help. With the I-Team, Brian New, CBS 11 News.
If you'd like to learn a little bit more about this targeted EIDL program, just go to our website. We have some information there on eligibility, as well as a map that shows which areas in DFW qualify as low income. For a small business owner, it is worth checking out.